Welcome everyone to the second session of the last day of QIP. So this will be a merged talk, and the first part of the talk will be given by Michal, and it's on multiple teleportation screens. Over to you, Michal.
Thank you very much. So let's start. Okay, sorry, I had some small problem. So we know that quantum teleportation is one of the most widely used primitives in quantum information science, which performs an arbitrary quantum state transfer between two separate systems. It involves pre-shared entanglement and consists of three stages: joint measurement on the teleported subsystem together with the shared state, a communication of the outcome of the measurement through a classical channel to receiver, and correction depending on the classical output obtained by Alice during the measurement. There is also a different teleportation procedure called port-based teleportation, which does not require the last step of correction. Here, parties share a number of ETR pairs, and after a global measurement, Bob just has to pick up right port pointed by a classical message I obtained by a measurement performed by Alice, and no further correction is needed. However, due to no programming theorem, the perfect transmission with finite number of shared entanglement pairs is impossible. And we have two variants of PBT. One is the deterministic scheme, when we always teleport our state, but the teleportation is imperfect. And to describe performance, we have to compute fidelity between the output and the input state. And the second scenario is a probabilistic scheme, whenever we succeed, teleportation is perfect with fidelity equal to one. And to learn about the efficiency of the protocol, we ask about the probability of not failing. So in other words, probability of success. Port-based had found a lot of very interesting applications in quantum information science, but today, rather than application, we ask about different question, namely, how many states, let's say K, can one faithfully teleport using port-based teleportation? So we can apply standard port-based teleportation with large dimension of the shared entanglement state. We can apply packaged PPT when we divide N port into K packages and then apply standard port-based teleportation. We can use recycling protocol when we reduce shared maximally entangled state after each round of teleportation. But today we focus on multi-port-based teleportation, which allow us to teleport composite system in one go. So in our scheme, parties also share N ETR pairs. Alice performed joint measurement on her half of the ETR pairs and the state to be teleported. And when we and then she transmits the measurement outcome to Bob, and Bob have to pick up his port in right order, which depends on the classical message. The channel in the cloud picture is the following, where by PI we denote measurements performed by Alice, and sigma I's are signal states, which come from tracing out over all bobs except those pointed by multi-index I. And our goal is to evaluate efficiency of the protocol, so the fidelity of the channel in the deterministic scheme, and in the probabilistic scheme, probability of success. And of course, we consider non-optimal case where parties share only PR pairs, and also the case where Alice optimized simultaneously over shared maximal entanglement states and measurements. We're gonna use some tools from representation theory, and to know which one, we have to identify symmetries in our problem. So let's consider some example where we have n equal to 4 ports and you want to teleport only 2 systems. So in total, we have 12 signals. If we pick up just any 2 of them, we can notice that from one signal to the second one, we can go just applying a permutation from the following causes. In the case of standard pole-based teleportation, where k equals to 1, we end up transposition of the following 4. There is also different symmetry, because we know that maximally entangled state is UU star invariant, where U denotes complex conjugation. So in particular here, our sigmas are U tensor 4, U star invariant. So in general case, our measurements and signals are invariant with respect to the following skew action of the unitary group and covariant with respect to the permutations coming from this coset. We can also deduce the following property, namely, if we take any swap operator and apply partial transposition with respect to one subsystem, we end up with a projector onto a maximally entangled state. So basically, we see that every sigma can be obtained from proper permutation after partial transposition, in our particular case, over fifth and sixth particle. So our conclusion is that whenever operator commutes with our skew action of unitary group, it belongs to the algebra of partially transposed permutation operators. And this algebra comes from ordinary algebra of permutation operators, but with the difference that on the last K subsystems, we apply transposition operation. So we can summarize that now all measurements and signals are elements of this algebra and also are covariant with respect to mentioned coset, Sn divided by Sn minus k. And since we identified all the symmetries occurring in our problem, we can simplify the computation using representation theory. So our goal is to find irreducible matrix representations of our algebra of partially transposed permutation operators. Of course, our two algebras are completely structurally different because here composition of two transposition give us identity, here not. Still, we can be motivated by standard sure-wide duality between unitary group and permutation group, because we know that actions of U tensor N and permutation operator commutes. So there is a basis which is called sure basis, in which Hilbert space decomposes into direct sum of such tensor products when the sum runs over all irreducible representation of permutation group, and this lambdas and this representations are labeled by Young diagrams, which can be represented graphically like here in the right corner. So also from the standard representation theory, we know that within every lambda, we can construct orthonormal operator bases, where here we have matrix elements of our representations, which are known, and corresponding projector onto every irreducible space. And we have constructed similar operators, but for commuting actions, our skew action of unitary group and partially transposed permutation operators. But here, labels are labeled by irreps of permutation group of Sn minus k and Sn. So in total, our projectors, which corresponds to p lambdas, are labeled by pairs of index alpha and mu. And in particular, this this allows us to diagonalize operator rho, which is which is sum over all signals. And it gives us a really easy way to compute row inverse. And this basically, together with semi-definite programming, lead us to direct expressions for entanglement fidelity when Alice and Bob share maximally entangled space and use mentioned square root measurements. In particular, for the equal to two, we can use theory of angular momentum to obtain really nice compact formula for the fidelity. Although in the optimized case, entanglement fidelity is given as a maximal eigenvalue of the following generalized teleportation matrix, which encodes a relation between Young diagrams. Similar situation we have in a probabilistic case, when in general case we have expression in terms of group theoretic parameters. In case of qubits, again, we use angular momentum representation. And remarkably here, in the optimal case, we have really nice and compact expression for probability of success. This, please recall that in the case of deterministic protocol, we couldn't be able to find nice closed expression for F. It's only given by in terms of some maximal value of teleportation matrix. So that's all from my side. Thank you very much and sorry for technical problems.
Okay, so good morning, everyone. And in the second part, I will concentrate on the results that allow for easier analysis of the performance of multi-port teleportation in comparison to the ones obtained within the framework of this algebra of partially transposed permutation operators. And basing on the equivalence between port-based teleportation and the state discrimination task, and adapting the bound on probability of successful discrimination of states from ensemble E provided by Koenig and Beji to our multiport scenario, we have obtained a lower bound for fidelity. In fact, two lower bounds, the weaker of which shall prove helpful when we discuss the asymptotic performance of MPBT. We can see that these bounds depend only on global parameters like number of ports N, number of particles that are teleported K, and dimensionality. And to obtain it, one had to calculate the trace of rho squared, which is maybe elementary in terms of tools used, but it was rather non-trivial combinatorial problem. And having this bound, we can compare the performance of MPBT against the pre-existing bounds, pre-existing protocols. In case of standard PBT, when we employ high dimensionality to stuff all the message in one port, this comparison is not interesting because such scenario is rather poor because the fidelity suffers a lot from the high dimensionality. The lower bound for the recycling protocol that was provided only in qubit case is again not so interesting because it behaves similarly to our bound presented in the previous slide, but is always weaker. The most interesting case to be compared is packaged PBT. And packaged PBT involves a division of the whole number of ports N into K packages and performing port-based teleportation within each package, either ordinary port-based teleportation or optimized one, OPBT for short. And we can define a joint fidelity in such scheme that is given by the product of the fidelities in each package. And comparing our lower bound with the fidelity in the packaged scenario, packaged protocol, we can observe an interesting phenomenon. In the beginning, for small n, we can see that our protocol, which is indicated by full circles, for every k, colors correspond to different values of k, outperforms the packaged PBT. But again, for every k, there exists some point after which the packaged PBT is better than at least our lower bound. But what one can observe that this point shifts to the right more and more whenever k increases. These gaps increase as well. So this, it suggests a question: can we adopt k to change together with n so that maybe in such scenario our new bound shows the usefulness of our new protocol? So let's define k to be dependent on n in such manner that it is a product of some real number a times n to the power of alpha, where alpha is real number from 0 to 1. And using the exact value for fidelity in optimized port-based teleportation and plugging it to the expression for the packaged version, we can calculate the limit when n goes to infinity, and we can see that faithful teleportation, that means the teleportation when the fidelity goes to 1 in infinity, is allowed only when alpha is smaller than 2/3. When alpha is greater than 2/3, the final the limiting fidelity is 0, and when it is exactly equal to 2/3, it's some finite number between 0 and 1, depending on a squared, a to the power of 3rd power. On the other hand, when we apply Bernoulli inequality to our weaker bound, the weaker of the two bounds that were presented for MPBT, we obtain then such expression, and we can see that whenever k is of order smaller than capital N, this expression goes to 1. On the other hand, when k is linear in N, provided that a is smaller than 1/2, the limiting fidelity is a finite number between 0 and 1. So it is a big improvement over packaged PBT, because we can see that the region where the fidelity finally, in the end, eventually reaches 1, is the whole region between 0 and 1 for our bound. So MPBT for sure is at least as good. And in terms of packaged PBT, it's only the region between 0 and 2/3. We can see that these functions, as they become thicker, they correspond to higher n's, and so they tend to step-like functions. And exactly similar reasoning can be applied to the teleportation employing so-called recycling protocol, which mainly comes to the fact that Alice and Bob can reuse the shared entanglement again and again, thanks to so-called recycling procedure, which comes to the fact that after Alice teleports first of k particles to, let's say, port Z, then Bob swaps with the first port, Alice and port Bob mark first port, and they perform again the teleportation without the marked ports, and they do it k times. And in case of qubits, there has been provided in 2013 a lower bound for such for fidelity in such scenario. But one can observe, and this bound behaves similarly to our bound in terms of asymptotics, but one can observe it's rather poor, because for small n, this bound is even negative. So summing up this discussion, we can see different regions that allow for faithful teleportation in terms of different protocols. We didn't discuss PBT, packaged PBT, since it's obviously worse than packaged optimized PBT. And in terms of MPBT and recycling, the asymptotic regions are the same, but this finite number is always smaller in terms of recycling. In the probabilistic case, unfortunately, we do not have such a nice lower bound, but restricting to the qubit case, we can use the expression given in terms of spin angular momentum, and using central limit theorem, we can express this limiting value in terms of Gaussian integrals. And one can observe that depending on how k depends on n, these integrals have different form. And here, whenever k is of order smaller than square root of n, so it corresponds to alpha smaller than 1/2, the teleportation is faithful, which is not so nice as in a deterministic case, because this region coincides with the optimal probabilistic, optimal packaged probabilistic scheme. In fact, we made it a little more. We computed using Berry-Essen theorem the limits for finite number of n confidence intervals in given in terms of these Gaussian integrals. But for the sake of asymptotics, we can concentrate only on these limiting values. However, when we consider optimized multi-port based teleportation protocol, OMPBT in short, with its remarkably simple formula, and consider d equal 2, qubit case, one can easily see that this probability in the limiting scenario is equal to 1 whenever k is of order smaller than capital N, and is some finite number whenever k is linear in N. So it again gives a much better region of possible values of parameter alpha, but allow for faithful teleportation. And of course, there are still some open questions that can be asked. One hasn't found the asymptotic expressions for fidelity in case of optimized multiport teleportation yet. What's more, one may ask if the expression for fidelity for a fidelity in case of PBT and MPBT can be expressed in more familiar way without referring to the language of irreducible of representation theory of symmetry of algebra of partially transposed permutation operators. And some efforts are made to simplify the measurements employed in this scenario, for example, by performing projective measurements. And finally, one could deliver a better, more general result concerning the recycling protocol, since now only the qubit case is provided. And the topics discussed in our talk are covered in detail in these papers. And that is all from us. Thank you very much for listening to our talk.
Right. Thanks to both of the speakers for the very nice talk. So we have some questions. Let me start with a question for Michal. So Maris Ozos is asking, is there a way to interpret the simple formula on your last slide for the probabilistic case where Alice's measurements are optimized? And I have, a very similar question. So you showed many formulas, and some of them you referred as nice, but they still contain the sums, kind of. So is there, like, do we know how to simplify them, at least understand what's the order of growth, like express them as theta of n something?
Okay, so maybe I start from the first part of the question. So except the direct interpretation that, you know, it gives us probability of success of our protocol, we don't have any other operational interpretation right now. So I would be really happy to hear. And regarding the efficiency of this group theoretical approach, I think it would be really good to use some approach from the paper of Matthias Tristan, Felix Litsky, and others, where they are able to evaluate the order of standard port-based teleportation using some tools, asymptotic tools of representation theory of symmetric group and unitary group, right? So maybe some combining their results with our results will lead to give precise scaling of the formula.
Yeah. Thank you very much. So then I see two questions actually that both ask about, so one is from Ernesto Galvao and another one from Florence Spillon. They ask about applications of this multiport teleportation, and specifically whether there could be some applications for measurement-based quantum computing or variants for creating programmable quantum processors, channel distribution. Mm-hmm. In attacks and so on. Whoever wants to answer that. I don't think.
Do you want, or should I answer? So maybe I will answer that. In ordinary port-based teleportation, right? Please notice that Bob has to just pick up a right port on his side, right? Here, he also needs to perform permutation of his ports to recover the original state. So this is a limiting factor for this protocol. So basically, the question is, we would have to find a way to somehow incorporate this correction into this channel discrimination or attacks on position verification, right? Our goal was rather to exploit the efficiency of existing schemes of the teleportation protocols and compare this efficiency with our new protocols. So you know, since Bob has to permute his port, then if you consider our scheme as a universal programmable quantum processor, operation which you apply to every port simply not always commutes with permutation which Bob has to apply, basically, right? So the question is, can you find some restrictions in which this permutation is not needed? For example, in IDD case, for sure, but I'm not sure is it enough general to have some application right now.
Thank you. So I would have one last question before we go on. Can you say anything about, so you need to implement certain measurements or something. Is something known about how to do it efficiently, like in terms of on a quantum computer? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's a really good question. So basically, port-based teleportation and our scheme, the measurements are quite hard to implement because they are of the high rank, basically, right? So our next goal is to find a new port-based teleportation variant in which we want to simulate this protocol by use of projective measurements. And then basically you can try to even, I believe that you can even try to prepare some experimental proposal, at least for some 3 or 4 ports for port-based teleportation, right? But it demands quite a different approach, right? Because you cannot consider some general POVMs of high rank, but you need to restrict yourself to von Neumann measurements and basically you lose a little bit of representation theory in PPT. But we have some partial results, and this is, it's possible to perform port-based teleportation by projective measurements.
Thank you very much for answering the questions and for the talks. So let's go on